Hi there. This is Katie with the channel Weather Shaman. Welcome if you're new, and a big hello to my returning subscribers. Today I have planned for you a spirit animal oracle card reading for the week of January 4th. Happy New Year. I hope that you had a lovely New Year's celebration. I'm going to be using the same spirit animal oracle card deck that I normally use for this reading, the Spirit Animal Oracle by Colette Baron Reed, for spirit animal guidance and inspiration on your life journey. Oftentimes, the natural world, the animal kingdom, and the spirit world communicate to us via subliminal messages that are delivered to us from animals that cross our paths, such as deer, owl, squirrels, and any other animals that may cross your path. There are deeper subliminal messages embedded that these animals are trying to deliver to us. But Happy New Year once again. If you would like to book a personal one-on-one reading with me, you can email me at weathershaman1111@gmail.com, and we can take a closer look at what's going on in your reality on a deeper, more personal level. Before we get started with today's reading, I'm going to go ahead and use my Tibetan singing bowl to open up your crown chakra, your divine channel, to help you to become more open and receptive to the messages that wish to come through to you today for your highest and greatest good. Breathe in positivity, love, and light. Hold your breath for a few seconds. And now breathe out and release all negativity from your day. Breathe in positivity, love, and light. Hold your breath for a few seconds. And now breathe out and release all negativity from your day. One more time. Breathe in positivity, love, and light. Hold your breath for a few seconds. And now breathe out and release all negativity from your day. Now let us begin with our reading for the week of January 4th. Dear angels, archangels, and ascended masters of the highest Christed light, please help give me and the viewers of this video spirit animal guidance and inspiration for everyone's highest and greatest good. Okay, so we have few cards that flew out. We have Vulture Spirit, which says nothing is wasted, knowing that the past is our greatest teacher. So let go of any guilt and shame that you may be experiencing from things that happened in your past. Time to let the past go and move forward. Move forward in perfect harmony and peace and understanding and alignment with who you came here to be on this earth, and trusting that everything happens for a reason and nothing happens by mistake. Everything is happening in divine order and divine timing. So just know that nothing from your past is wasted. If you see turkey, vulture, or large birds overhead in your rearview mirror or in your windshield, if you're driving, if you see the birds above your head as you're driving, just know the birds are reminding you that nothing is wasted from your past. The past is your greatest teacher, okay? And we have Horse Spirit, which is all about embracing your freedom. Time to take back your freedom. Free your mind. It all starts with freeing your mind and learning to free your thinking and think for yourself. And it's okay to question things, question what we've been taught, question belief systems, and to let go of any old, outdated belief systems that may no longer be serving you. Belief systems that you took on maybe from your family or your upbringing or society or school systems or academia that may no longer be serving you. Time to question these belief systems and ask, are these beliefs that I've taken on truly mine? Do they feel right in my heart and my soul? Or are these beliefs that I've taken on from others because I was expected to believe in the same things that they were? Okay, really time to reevaluate your belief systems, especially going into 2021. It's a new year, time to start anew, a fresh, clean slate, mentally, physically, spiritually, and emotionally. Time to free your mind from the system. Free your mind and you free your life for a lifetime. And get in touch with your inner child. Go out and play. Do something that you love doing, that you enjoy, whether that's going outside on a swing set and swinging on a swing, or going on a jungle gym, or playing outside in nature and climbing a tree, or maybe playing a video game or a board game. Anything to bring out your inner child, to have fun and lighten up the mood. Not everything is supposed to be about to-do lists and staying busy and making money. Life is more about balancing responsibility with fun and finding a way to really allow more time for fun, to get in touch with our inner child and have a good time too, for we all deserve to be happy, joyous, and free. You watching this video, you deserve to be happy, joyous, and free, and to do what you love in this life and follow your joy always, okay? And being sure that you're surrounding yourself with people who love you unconditionally, who inspire you, who uplift you, and who support you for you wanting to follow your joy, okay? You deserve that. And we have Ant Spirit, which is telling you it's time to collaborate. Get together with like-minded souls who are on a similar journey or mission as you in this life. What are your goals? What are your dreams? What are your core values and morals? Go ahead and take time to go within and reevaluate what's truly important to you and what your soul is calling you to do during this time here on Earth. And then find your soul tribe, whether that be online, virtually, through Facebook groups, Instagram accounts, YouTube channels, and chat forums, and writing in comment sections of videos. Go ahead and start collaborating and putting yourself out there and meeting like-minded souls. Once again, this can be virtually online or it can be in person. There are still small meetup groups happening in person in some areas of the world. So do some research and some digging and see what's going on in your area, if there is anything going on. And if not, once again, we have the internet too to collaborate with people. So go ahead and put yourself out there, because we are stronger in numbers. And this new year of 2021 is going to be about expressing the importance of unity, us coming together to make a global impact, to make positive changes in this world, to help bring more love and light and hope to others who are maybe in a period of suffering or turmoil at this time. You watching this video have a unique ability to uplift others and inspire others and spread joy and love and hope to others. You may not realize it, but you were born with unique gifts and abilities to shed light on people, to shine your light, to help others, to give them hope when they feel like there's maybe no way out. You have that ability to uplift people and inspire them. So just know that just by you smiling at someone or saying hello and greeting a stranger, that can make the world of difference in somebody's life. So never let anybody dim your light. Always keep following your joy and shining your light brightly, okay? Because that is helping people. You may not even realize it, but people are looking up to you at this time and are watching and observing what you're doing. And you inspire people that you probably didn't even think you were inspiring. So just keep shining your light and following your joy and being happy, because happiness is contagious. And when I was pre-shuffling the deck, I had a few cards fly out as well that I wish to share with you. The Koi Fish Spirit, which says there is always enough. So let go of any financial fears that you may have at this time. Know that your basic needs will always be met, and it's okay to ask for help if you ever need to ask for help. And just trust that the divine is protecting you and supporting you and guiding you. You will always have your basic needs met, okay, dear loved one? It's gonna be okay. All right, just affirm it. I am abundant. I am love. I am worthy of assistance if I need it. okay? Just know there's always enough to go around. We are meant to live in abundance. We are meant to live in a prosperous state of being. Just know there is plenty to go around. If we were to share the resources on this earth equally amongst us all, we would all live in perfect abundance. So let's get back to that. It's all about coming together and unifying and sharing with one another, going back to a barter type of system, okay? And offering and exchanging services to one another and helping each other, finding other ways besides just money to exchange things with one another. Because money is simply an exchange of energy. They call it currency because it's merely a current of energy, right? What goes in must come out. It's always an exchange of energy. So find other ways to exchange energy with people. And the more that we have gratitude for what we already have in our life, the more that abundance is able to come in. We can get on that abundance frequency if we practice more gratitude each and every day. That's one of my secrets. I have a gratitude list in my head that I repeat. I am so grateful for my home. I'm so grateful for my guinea pig. I am grateful for my family, my friends, my loved ones. And I'm grateful for this YouTube channel, for you watching this video. You make this YouTube channel possible. What are some things you're grateful for that will help you get on the abundance frequency mindset? And squirrel spirit is telling you to believe in yourself. If you see any squirrels running around looking at you funny, that's them telling you to believe in yourself. Stop doubting yourself and doubting your abilities. You are so gifted and you have unique gifts and talents that are meant to be expressed with the world. Okay, so keep putting yourself out there. And if you haven't put yourself out there, do what you can to go within and do some healing work and practice some self-love and self-care so that you can really go within and tap into your power and start sharing your beautiful abilities with the world. You have much to share. So go ahead and start sharing what's on your mind with others, what's on your heart, because that is going to help you meet more like-minded individuals. And the mouse spirit says, tend to the small things. Yes, those little things we don't want to do, like pay the bills or, you know, go and get something fixed or change a light bulb or clean out clutter. If there are little things that you need to do that you've been putting off, make sure you get those done. You don't need to rush and hurry and do it all fast, but tending to the small things can help alleviate some stress and anxiety. You know, taking care of things that we may have been procrastinating on, that can help alleviate stress and anxiety and make us feel a sense of accomplishment. So just remember to tend to the small things this week as well. And I'm going to go ahead and recap these guys. So if you see any turkey vultures or hawks or big birds when you're driving, just know that these birds are telling you that nothing in your past is wasted. So do not have any regrets or remorse for anything that happened in your past. Everything happened for a reason and is continuing to happen for a reason. So just trust the process. And horse spirit is reminding you that freedom is yours. Free your mind and clear out any old, outdated belief systems. And keep following your joy and doing activities that make you feel free and happy to be alive. Get in touch with that free-spirited nature that you were born with as a child. And just do more of what makes you happy, okay? Go outside into nature. Look at the beautiful birds and trees and feel that sunlight upon your face. It's beautiful. I'm doing that right now on my balcony, getting in touch with the sun. It's a nice warm winter day in the 60s here in North Carolina. So I'm taking advantage of this warmer weather while it's here to breathe in some fresh air, some prana, and to just reset energetically. Nature can be so healing. And once again, we have squirrel spirit, which is telling you to believe in yourself. Stop doubting your abilities, okay? You are amazing and you are so gifted and talented in so many unique things. And ant spirit is telling you to collaborate, for we're stronger in numbers and unity is key. And mouse spirit is reminding you to tend to the small little things and time to go ahead and take care of them so you feel better in the long run. And then koi fish spirit is reminding you there's always plenty to go around. So get on that abundance mindset frequency and remember, you were meant to live in abundance. You were meant to live in a prosperous type reality. And just know that you are worthy of receiving abundance in your life and living in an abundance, because the more abundant we are, the more we're able to help others and share with others and raise the vibration of planet Earth. It benefits us all. It's all about how we channel and use abundance in our lives. And what I love is that the more resources we have access to, the more we're able to share love and light and hope and happiness and good vibes with others. And that's what this new earth that we're creating is all about, is service to others, helping one another, sharing with one another, and coming together to share our gifts and our talents and our services. Once again, more of a barter system type way of living is emerging. So what are some unique talents, services, hobbies that you can offer others? What are some unique gifts that you have that maybe you haven't tapped fully into yet? Go within this week and discover that. Okay, so we have some beautiful cards, beautiful readings. For those of you who have any aquariums with fish in it, take some time to meditate as the fish swim in the aquarium and just allow it to help you to heal emotionally. And remember to go with the flow always. I love watching fish swim in aquariums because it reminds me to just go with the flow. And also YouTube has a lot of cool virtual aquariums that you can watch. They have a lot of beautiful relaxing meditation music videos with aquariums and fish on YouTube you can look up too. That might be really healing to the subconscious mind this week as well. Now, what I'm going to do is send you some crystal Reiki energy healing to close out this reading, to send you good vibes and positive energy and healing wherever you may need it for this upcoming week of January 4th. Just relax and take a few deep breaths as I send Reiki energy healing to you for your highest and greatest good, in perfect comfort, harmony, balance, and alignment. Sending you emotional healing, mental healing, physical healing, and spiritual healing for your highest and greatest good, and perfect comfort, harmony, balance, and alignment. And now going around the top of your head, balancing your crown chakra, clearing away any racing thoughts and clearing out any old, outdated belief systems that may no longer be serving you. Letting those go to make room for new and better, beautiful things this new year of 2021. And balancing your third eye, Ajna Chakra, helping you to see more clearly, helping you to see beyond illusion, and strengthening your sixth sense, and balancing and aligning your throat chakra, clearing channels of communication, helping you to speak your truth more boldly and courageously. And balancing and aligning your Anahata heart chakra, clearing away any grief and replacing this grief and sadness with unconditional love, joy, and happiness. And balancing and aligning your solar plexus chakra, increasing your levels of courage, strength, willpower, and perseverance. And balancing and aligning your sacral chakra, increasing your levels of creativity, sensuality, and sensual expression. And balancing and aligning your Muladhara root chakra, helping you to feel more safe, secure, and rooted to the earth and rooted in your soul purpose and your life purpose here on earth. And just cleansing your aura and wiping away any remaining negativity at this time. Just relax. Know that you are loved, you are safe, and all is well. Okay. Now I'm sending you an abundance of peace, love, and light. From me to you, go forth in perfect love, harmony, balance, comfort, and alignment. Namaste, beautiful soul.